And now I want to finish up a story we heard a while back. This is a lady that wrote me. Her and her husband have kind of been outside the box for a while, got connected to a home group, enjoyed it. It was part of a larger thing, but they were basically into the home group part of it. They were asked to lead a home group. Would you guys be open to leading one? And they're going, yeah, we'd be happy to do that if that helps you guys. And then it was, well, you know what? You guys haven't signed the covenant yet. We've got this covenant. We all sign. And to be a home group leader, you've got to sign it. And their response was, I don't really need to sign it. I think the new covenant's good enough for us. Don't need another covenant. Don't need to sign it. We're not interested. To which the guy comes back, the pastor guy, you know what? God gave us this covenant. So we can have accountability, read control. Whenever you hear accountability, read control. We can have control. Now, I don't want to blame the dude. I've never done written covenants, but I tell you, I've been part of all kinds of membership things we tried to do when I was a pastor, some way to be responsible about the people that attend here and knowing who's committed and who's not. But every way we tried to do it didn't work. And when you double down, I mean, here's the deal. I'm not going to sign your covenant. Well, God gave us this covenant. And doggone, you would sign it if you weren't in rebellion to him. Now, that never gets said. It's said much more nicely than that, but that's what's being conveyed. And they still said, if you remember, we had this a few months ago, no, we're not really interested, so we just soon not lead. And that was tearing this couple apart. They really wanted to get with people who are growing and have them in their home and do that, which, you know what, you can still do if you don't do it as an official part of the deal. You can still open your home and have people in and love them up, and all that's really good. But they said they wouldn't. Well, that story went on. She says, I got this email probably a month ago. It said, one last follow-up. It's not good. Later, we received a private message from the leader's wife, and she asked us if we'd be willing to share with her, and by leader, she meant a worship leader, not the pastor's wife, why we did not sign the membership covenant. She said over the past 18 months, God had been teaching her a lot about covenants, and she said, if I knew then what I know now, I would not have signed it. And she continued, when I heard that you could not lead the Bible study because you would not sign it, I knew the timing was not coincidence, but divine. So we planned to meet and talk more about that. And before the meeting even took place, she called to say that she knows that this is not right for her. And she went to the church office to renege on her signature. She'd been working part-time for the church office for the last 4 years. They told her she has a problem with submission and she needs to obey. They also told her that if she does not sign, she may not serve in any capacity. The same thing they told us. Her husband is the worship leader. It's not a paid position. He's not at the same spiritual place she is. He has no problem with the membership covenant, but he supports 100% her decision and believes that she is hearing and being directed by the Holy Spirit. Today, the church told him by email, because a personal conversation would be awkward, that if his wife does not sign, that he is no longer allowed to lead worship or to serve, and that the people, that would be us, in their small group, have infected them. Husband's eyes have now been opened. He sees that it is not as innocent as he thought it was, that the hearts of those leaders have been revealed. How could they, after knowing them for over 4 years, now be throwing them away so callously? So it really is about the church institution and not about loving, growing, and making disciples. We are now most likely the cancer that needs to be extracted, and they are too. So there it is. Not unexpected, I suppose, but heartbreaking nonetheless. I gave her your book, So You Don't Want to Go to Church Anymore. She said she found in the pages of this powerful book what her heart could not put into words. Wow. You know, that story makes me as sad as anything, because I know I've done things like that. And in the name of, I have a responsibility to this institution, it ultimately means I have to take control of you. Any conformative-based event demands taking control. It just does.